just to listen to a hymn. The hymn that he listened to was At the Cross. The next Sunday he wanted to go back to hear the same hymn. And then the third Sunday he went back to listen to the same hymn. And that's when he received Christ as Savior. 3 months later, he was baptized. He started working in children's ministry. It was fun, but it wasn't for him. He never really felt called to work with kids as much as with adults. Especially with senior adults. And later on, the church in Mazatenango disintegrated. So the convention asked him to come and pastor for 2 years to revive the work. But now he's been there 45 years. So there was not enough support for him to be full-time pastor, so he started bivocationally with a bakery. So he could work at the bakery, he could have the bakery to sustain his family. The church grew, so he was full-time now at church. They gave him 10 quetzales every month. He had 4 kids. His wife passed away. His youngest child was 4. His oldest child was 9. So he was working for his family and for the church. And thanks to God, in the course of the ministry, they've organized 13 churches. One in Cobán, one in Texaltenango, one in San Marcos, and all the rest of them are in this area. They have 5 missions. He feels great. His children have graduated with a lot of sacrifice. He had shoes that looked nice on the top, but they were falling apart on the bottom. He feels very satisfied that his children graduated. And they have good jobs. The oldest is a congressman. After 45 years, he doesn't want to go back to the Capitol. He wants to be here, he feels strong. He wants to share this with you. Life is from God. He can take it whenever he wants. But my plan is I want to be here till 2030 to work with Ollie. The work really needs help. He's happy to be with us. Thank you, and God bless you.